lot of things going on. So
3 minutes. Everybody, and this is another edition of Sharing with Sherry. And today I want to talk about something that I have gone through my lifetime, from when I was a child all the way even up until today and this time of day, even into my adult years in life. And that's what I want to talk about: doing your own life, about living your own life. When I was growing up, my mom never really let us, me and my sisters and my brothers, do a lot of things that everybody else did in the neighborhood. She was kind of strict on us, and we couldn't go outside or go outside whenever we wanted to. We had to go when she said go, and sometimes, you know, we had to come in before everybody else, or there's certain places she wouldn't let us go, and it was kind of hard. And I don't know about how you guys did it, but it was really hard for me. And I always felt like, after doing that, my mom kept us like that, that I always had to try to fit in. When I felt isolated from my friends and the people that I was hanging out with and going to school with, I just felt a little isolated, and I felt very insecure. So I always felt like I had to fit in. So I began to try to fit into this group and fit into that group. And when I got into high school, I begged my mom to let me be a cheerleader. And it was in eighth grade and then high school years, and I begged her to let me be a cheerleader, because I used to look around and see the cheerleaders were real popular. Everybody liked them. Everybody hung around the cheerleaders. I thought, wow, that's pretty cool. I need to do that. So I had to beg my mom, and finally she let me go out for cheerleading, and I made it, and I was a cheerleader, and I felt like I was just on top of the world, you know, real popular girl, and everybody liked you, and everybody wanted to hang around the cheerleader. But I found myself trying to keep doing things to always fit in with other people. I always was worried about, what are people thinking about me? What are they going to say? And how are they going to react to me? But I just kept doing it and doing it and trying to figure out, you know, how can I make people like me? And as I began to get older, I began to realize that people are always not going to like you. And I always found out that it doesn't matter if they like you or not. Sometimes and all the time, it's just best to do you. You have to learn to live your own life and live your own dreams. I had to find out for myself some things. I had to find the hard way, trying to fit in with people and be around people, hang out around people. And a lot of times I got in trouble because I was hanging around with the wrong crowd. And then eventually, you know, I started to figure out, you know, well, they don't really like me because of who I am. They just like me because they wanted me to be around them, but they really didn't like me. So I had to figure out for myself. And even after I got past that, I always thought that if I would be around certain people, I'd fit in. But I've learned some hard lessons in life. And I've learned, even to this day, that you have to learn how to do yourself. You know, God has plans for your life. God has plans for your only life. And it's best that you trust God and work out those plans for you. You know, sometimes people are always trying to put their life on you and put all their plans on you. And then when you try to do something on your own, that's where a little jealousy come in. People get like, well, who does she think she is? Or what does she think you doing? And when you try to, you know, see that, you know, I don't want to do this anymore. I want to go my own way. I want to do my own thing. I want to be my own person. And then all of a sudden, people just start looking at you funny, and then they treat you funny. And sometimes that hurt me. And I would, you know, go in my room sometimes. I remember laying in my bed at night. You know, sometimes I would even cry. That would hurt me because I'm like, well, I'm trying to be their friend and they don't like me. I'm trying to do what they want me to do and they don't like me. But I had to come to a point to where it don't matter if people like you or not. What's the most important thing is that you do you, that you do the things that you want to do that makes you happy. So I began to find things deep down on the inside of me that really, really made me happy. those things in life that were for Sherry. You know, they say, God's got blessings with your name on it. Well, I wanted everything with my name on it. And I began to look for those things in my life. And I liked public speaking in high school. I was on the debate team and I was pretty good at it. And I began to think I loved to journalism and I loved to talk and I loved to motivate people. And I ran into some different roadblocks and some hard times. Well, you know, who does she think she is telling people that? Or what does she know? And little did they know that I was telling them things that I was going through experiences in my life. So I just began to do me, and I began to forget about what people say about me. You have to live your life for yourself. Don't make nobody's dreams your dream. You make your own dreams. Don't let nobody persuade you into doing something that you don't want to do just because you're trying to make them happy or you don't want them to get mad at you. If they get mad, so what? Who cares? You just keep moving. People don't have nowhere to put you. People can't do nothing for you. But what you have to do is you have to stand for yourself. And most of all, you have to believe in yourself. You have to believe in what's on the inside of you. You have to believe in your heart. I can do this. I can make this work. I can live my life for me. So as I began to get older, even in my adult years and even on my job, you know, it's, you know, I tried to fit in where I was supposed, where I could be on my job or fit in with the people at work. But I had to realize that I was going to work for me and I was doing a job for me. I come to do my job. You know, I would hear about how this one and that one and how much fun they was having. And, you know, it sounded like it was so exciting. But sometimes all the excitement is not always what it seemed to be. Sometimes people get all that excitement and trouble is around sometimes. So I'm glad that I, you know, stuck to what Sherry wanted to do and I stuck to what I wanted to do. But I'm learning that in life you have to do what's best for you. Find those things in your life that's encouraging. Sometimes you got to encourage yourself. When nobody else is around, you have to encourage yourself and you have to know that I can do this. And if people don't like me, they just don't like me. So what? As long as I like myself and I love myself and I can encourage myself, I'm going to make it. Don't let anybody stop you from doing those things in your life that you want to do. If you have a dream, dream big. If Michael Jordan never would have started bouncing that basketball late nights in the hour when he was outside in his garage and shooting the ball in a bucket and those in the bucket and just running and do what he wanted to do, he'd have never succeeded the way he is right now. If Serena Williams' parents wouldn't have got her and Venus out there on that tennis court and had them out there, and I hear her tell her story sometime, her parents never let them do a lot of things, but they were encouraging them and trying to keep them to do the right thing, then be the best that they can be, because he knew that there was something that was in them. So when you know that is something that's in you, you put your best foot forward. You put your best effort forward. Everybody has something inside of them, but don't let anybody stop you. Don't let anybody discourage you for doing those things that you want to do. I tell you, when you get to the point to where you don't care, you'll be the best person that you ever been in your life. People will just assume that, oh, she's doing this and she's doing that. And they will assume all these things. But no, they just don't know that you're doing that for yourself. You're reaching deep down inside and say, I'm going to make it. I'm going to be something one day. I'm going to be somebody. How many of us have ever sat around and even thought about that? You know, I'm going to be somebody one day. I bet President Obama sat around one day and he said, I'm going to be somebody one day. And when he went out there and he worked hard and did what he wanted to do, look what happened to them. He came the president of the United States. And that means that you can do anything that you want to do, but do what you want to do. Don't let nobody stand in your way. No man, no woman, no boy, no girl, no boyfriend, no girlfriend, nobody. Don't let anybody stand in your way from what you want to do. Do what you want to do. And when you do that, you'll be happy. You'll be at peace. You'll be at rest, because nobody can live their life for you. Nobody can do the things that you want to do but you. And when you do those, put your best foot forward, like I said. Do your hardest. Go at it. Don't never get up. Yeah, you're going to fall. You're going to make mistakes. We all fall down. Nobody's perfect. But this, the saying says, nothing beats a failure but a try. If you fall down, keep getting up. Keep getting up. If you get a no, keep on going. We're going to get a lot of no's in our life. We're going to get a lot of discouragement in our life. But we have to keep going. We got to keep pushing. Don't never lose your push. Don't ever lose your fight. Keep fighting and know that you can make it. Know that you can do those things that you want to do. Don't let people stop you. Don't let anybody get in your way. Sometimes people get jealous. You know, there's a saying that said, misery loves company. You know, people don't want to see you make it because they not making it. And they don't want to be nothing, and they don't want you to be anybody. And them the type of people that you want to get rid of. All that negativity. Get rid of the negativity in your life. You can make it. You can do it. You can try it. It's all kind of resources and all kind of help that you can get now, and you can get out there. But don't let anybody stop you from pursuing your dreams. Dreams are God gives us those dreams, and we get them dreams inside of us. And one day you keep pushing at them. Those dreams can and they will become reality. But don't let people talk you into anything and anything to do. I hear the word gullible. Don't let people have you being so gullible that you will just believe and all the doubt and everything. Don't do that. You can do you. You can make it. I tell you, when I finally learned how to do that, and I finally woke up one day and I said, you know what, Sherry, you can be whatever you want to be. And I began to move on and move forward with my life and move forward with those things that I like to do. Not nobody else, but I began to do those things that Sherry wanted to do. And when I did that, I tell you, a lot of doors have been opening. A lot of things opened for me. You know, I'm got to the point to where I just didn't care anymore. I'm not going to do this. You know, one thing, you can always do something. And if it don't work, at least you can say you try. But it's you doing it, not anybody else. It's you doing it. Live your life for you. Don't let people discourage you. Don't let people make you feel like, okay, I can't do it. Well, they say I can't do it. No, don't accept that. Don't accept those things in your life. You can do it and you can make it. You do what you want to do. That's one thing. And as I got older, and me and my mom used to have talks before she passed away. And this is a couple of things that she had told me. And she said, don't you ever stop giving up on yourself, Sherry. You can do those things in your life. I've had other people tell me that, but when my mom told me that before she passed away, that was the best thing that any advice that anybody ever gave me. And I appreciated that from her. And she told me, she said, you hold your head up. You keep going. You keep going and you keep doing those things that you want to do. All you have to do is pray. Keep praying. God will show you. And if you're not sure, let God show you. The Bible says, lean not to your own understanding. In all thy ways, God will acknowledge you and he will direct your path. Let him direct your path. Don't let nobody else take you down their pathway. Don't let nobody else take you down their road. That road and that pathway is for them. You know, and some people want you, well, come go with me. No, I can't go the way you're going because it's another place and a better place. And I tell people, I'm not trying to be funny. I'm not trying to act like I'm better than anybody else because I'm not. I'm not better than anybody else. But I just got to know what's good for me. I got to know what's good that I can do. And I'm not going to let nobody stop me from doing that. Determination. We have to be determined. You know, when you try to work on something, you know, like you putting a puzzle together and you're determined that I'm going to get this puzzle together. I'm going to do this puzzle down to the last piece. And one thing about puzzles, they're very, very tricky because sometimes the pieces look like they fit in the spot and it looks like a fit. But when you look back, you be like, that don't fit in there. That's not where that piece go. And you have to take it out and you got to find the right piece. So don't allow pieces, people to try to make you fit into their puzzle. If you don't fit into nobody else's life, then that life is not meant for you to be in. If that piece don't fit, don't go around trying to make yourself fit here and fit there and fit all over here. God's got a certain spot just for you. And when you step back and you get all the pieces of that puzzle together and you see the work that you do and you can see the reward, you know, when you get that puzzle done and it's all put together, it makes you feel good because you did it yourself. You didn't have anybody else to help you. You figured it out. You figured out where the pieces went. You trusted where the pieces went. You tried and it didn't work. So you got this piece and you got that piece and you tried. And then finally, when that puzzle came all together and you look at it and you be like, man, I did that. All the time and the effort and the determination that I had put into it, and the puzzle finally became complete. And that's how it is in life. When you finally get determined to do those things in your life, those things that you want to do, and when it's all said and done, you can stand tall and say, yes, I did this. Yes, I can. You know, Nike got the saying that says, just do it. Sometimes you just got to step out. Sometimes you got to not be afraid. Don't be afraid. The fear come in. We bind that spirit of fear. But don't let the fear come in and stop you from doing those things in your life. So stand tall. Hold your head up. Hold your head up high. God's got plans for you. Plans of good and not evil. Plans to prosper you and give you an expected end. And I promise you that if you trust in that, that it will never fail. So you do those things in your life. Do you. Don't let nobody discourage you. Don't let nobody try to control your life and tell you what to do. Think for yourself. That's what we have to do. We have to think for ourselves. We got to know within our heart, I can do this. It's okay to have friends. It's okay to ask for advice sometime. But you take that and you think about it, pray about it. And if it's for you, it's for you. But if it's not, it's not. But you got to do those things in your life that's for you. Don't let nobody ever discourage you. I'm telling you, don't let nobody ever stop you from reaching your goals, reaching your dreams. You can do it. You can make it. God put us here for a reason and a purpose. We're going to fall. We're going to make mistakes. Sometimes it's going to work. Sometimes it's not going to work. But that's when you pick yourself up and say, you know what? I tried that. It didn't work. So if there must be another way. So go out there and find that way. Don't let people get in your way. Don't let nobody stand in the way. Get out there and try that way. And I promise you that it will work. You can do it. Put forth the effort, the determination, get it in your mind, get it in your heart. But most of all, you got to see the vision. We all need to see a vision. The Bible says, write the vision down and make it plain. If you got to write it down, write it down so you can remember. But see your vision. You have to visualize me. I can do this. You have to visualize. I can make it like this. You have to visualize those things in your life. I can do it. Yeah, make it take a little bit longer than somebody else, but so what? The Bible says the race is not given to the swift, but to those that endure to the end. Just don't give up. Keep pushing. Keep pressing. See the vision. Write that vision down. And whatever it is, you do your best to do it. Don't let nobody influence you into doing things that you don't want to do. And when I began to see those things in my life, and sometimes I had to let some people go. I had to let down some friends. I had to let down even family. I had to step aside and let go and let God show me what to do. But I'm telling you, if you do it yourself, live your best life, trust and believe in God. And when you do that, he will trust and believe in you, and you can do it if you try. And I'm telling you, when you see the vision and you write it down, make a plan, you do all of that, God will show you the way. But I'm telling you, don't let nobody stand in your way from ever doing those things that you want to do. Because there's a great reward. When you want to see the reward, when you get to the end of that finish line, when you cross over that finish line, there's a great reward. Don't let nobody stop you from doing those things that you want to do. Be yourself. Do what's good for you. And when you do that, I promise you that you will make it and you will be one of the happiest peoples ever. Happy for you and happy for yourself. Thank you. Bye-bye. All right, thank you everybody for listening in today. And if you have some comments or you have some ideas that you would like to bring to Sharon with Sharon, just leave them in the comment section when you look at the video. And I'll be sure to look at each and every one. And until next time, I will see you.